Hi, I'm Patu from Free FinCal, and today I have just published the July to September 2020 Plumbline list. Plumbline, as you know, is my handpicked list of mutual funds, which I initially started in about September 2017 to accompany the robo-advisory template. And this has got a set of funds in different categories and so on. And the last Plumbline was published on April 4th. A few weeks later, Franklin closed its fund. Franklin Ultra Short was part of Plumbline, but as a high risk option. There were several reactions to it and my own learnings from it. I have compiled it all in today's post. You can have a go look at that article. But let me just get to the choices in this video so that I don't bother you with all the nitty-gritties. There is a disclaimer. I would suggest strongly that you please read the disclaimer and use the funds. I would demand that by watching this video, I assume that you are going to read the disclaimer or at least aware of it. All right, so we're going to start with overnight funds. Overnight is a very ultra conservative option. It's really not necessary for most retail investors. You have L&T overnight fund, Axis overnight, UTI overnight, pretty much any fund will do, just something low cost will do, but it's too conservative. I mean, it's over protective. You don't really need it. You can go with a liquid fund for an investment duration of a few months and above. Quantum liquid is all right. Parak liquid is fine. They're not exactly the lowest in terms of expense ratio, but they're fairly all right in terms of credit risk. That Quantum at least has got a very good history of low credit risk exposure. Parak is new. So far in its history, it has had sovereign bonds, but we have to see. So equity arbitrage, I use this fund for my son's goal as a debt component, because of the volatility, lower volatility. Some of our money is also in my wife's portfolio on this as part of the emergency fund and so on. So it can be volatile over the short term. So don't use it for just a few months and so on. And you can ask, why am I using it for my emergency fund? This is not my only emergency fund. My primary emergency fund is basically in an SB account. But this is my second tier, third tier, something like that. And it's not much of a fund. It's just about a month's expense, not more than that. So you should understand the volatility risk in that it can be volatile, especially during, when the market is more turbulent and so on. Don't expect too much returns from it, about 6-ish percentage. Essentially, tax benefits for those in 30% slab and long-term goals, this will work quite well. It can take into account some amount of direct equity exposure, about 5%, but they typically don't do it. But please recognize that arbitrage funds only have to invest 65% in arbitrage opportunities. The rest can be in risky bonds. So you have to be careful when you choose funds here. Money market, ultra short term. Franklin Savings Fund was what I recommended earlier. Because of all this business with redemptions and scare about Franklin, the fund fell 67% in AUM, but is still working. So that tells you at least that segment of the market is fairly liquid. If you don't want Franklin Savings, go for ICICI approved money market, HDFC money market. This is for 1 year and above kind of investing. 10-year gilt is what I would recommend for a long-term goal. You can go for SBI Magnum Constant Maturity or ICICI Constant Maturity Fund. This is more like an index fund. You will not have the fund manager playing with the duration, and sometimes there is a risk of getting it wrong and so on. This is a better fund for long-term goals. I've shown that SIPs will work very well for gilts, and also how you can time using double moving averages. I have the tool for that and so on. So for ELSS funds, this particularly, be careful, don't use it unless you really need it. Aditya Birla Tax Relief 96 or DSP Tax Saver, they're consistent performers. You can check them out. Parak Tax Saver Fund is also an option because more or less it's a clone of Parak, the value fund. So it's long-term equity fund, whatever they call it. Aggressive hybrid or balanced fund or equity oriented balanced fund, HDFC hybrid equity, formerly known as HDFC balanced, ICICI equity and debt are fairly good picks in this category. Multi-asset, I see multi-asset. By the way, I use Parag Parikh also. Oh, sorry, Parag Parikh is coming here. Multi-cap is coming here. I use, I use HDFC hybrid equity for my retirement goal. So multi-asset, I use ICICI multi-asset for my son's education goal. It was formerly ICICI balanced, I just left it on. It can be a volatile fund because it uses gold and equity and so on. If you want some gold in your portfolio, some kind of timing, dynamic asset allocation associated with a multi-asset allocation, then this fund may work for you. But you should keep your expectations reasonable. Multi-cap Parag Parikh long-term equity is fairly good. It has a very good track record. That's what I use. Quantum long-term equity I have removed. I still have some exposure, but I think it does not bet the benchmark for 7 years, 8 years, maybe even 10 years now. So it's going to be a tough job recommending it or holding on to it. So you can get rid of it. But they could do well if the market imbalance going forward is more or less removed. Same goes for ICICI Value Discovery also. Index fund, UTA index, HDFC, Sensex Nifty index. UTA also has a Sensex index, I think, I don't know. You can use that as a single fund for your equity, just the large caps. Or you can have a blend of large and mid caps by having 50% Nifty fund, a 50% Nifty Next 50 fund. UTI or ICICI Nifty Next 50 will work. Or you can have a slightly different blend of 70% Nifty 50, 30% of Nifty Next 50 and so on. Anything lower than 20% of Nifty Next 50, if you want to use, you might as well use Nifty 100, which is Axis 100, the index fund. Balanced Advantage or the Dynamic Asset Allocation Fund, ICICI Balanced Advantage has a very good track record. Of course, this is not an explicitly rule-based Balanced Advantage fund, but it is done quite well using their PB-based model. Mid-cap, small-cap funds. This time I've removed any explicit recommendations for mid-cap and small-cap because we saw that very few of them are able to beat the Nifty Next 50. But from this edition on, I will leave the consistent mid-cap, small-cap performance. I will publish this and just leave the links to it. It's up to you to use them. So that is the summary of Plumbline July-September 2020. Let's see what the future holds. Bye-bye.